德克萨斯州中西部小镇斯威特沃特声名鹊起，有人称赞，有人嗤之以鼻。1958年，一场号称世界上最大的响尾蛇围捕行动。每年三月的第二个周末，当地非营利性 Sweetwater Jaycees 会举办活动，猎杀和围捕数千磅响尾蛇。届时，毒蛇会从它们的巢穴中出来，在春季进行繁殖。在举行集会的体育馆狂欢般的环境中，成千上万的游客观看组织者从响尾蛇中提取毒液，并将其剥皮制成皮革制品。一些游客向 Sweetwater Jaycees 支付费用，让他们在附近的牧场进行有向导的狩猎。为了把响尾蛇从他们的巢穴里哄出来，人们在岩石缝隙中喷洒汽油。亚利桑那大学的响尾蛇专家和研究科学家马特·古德表示，这些杀死蛇的围捕，尤其是斯威特沃特的蛇，表明缺乏人性。
I think they're absolutely horrific. I mean, it's hard for me to think of any other interaction that humans have with wildlife that could be worse, you know, or more abhorrent. I mean, they're morally wrong, right? I mean, this circus-like atmosphere that they have around these things, it's ridiculous. To me, it shows a complete lack of respect for life, you know?
2016年，德克萨斯州公园和野生动物部推迟考虑禁止在蛇窝使用汽油。一些科学家称，那里生活着濒临灭绝的昆虫。根据林城毒理学资源网站的数据，西部菱纹斑纹响尾蛇等响尾蛇是德克萨斯州这一地区的常见物种。
What's up, girl? How you doing? I've had my day.
So we'll donate these or sell these to research. We can't really sell it for medical purposes because we're not in a sterile environment. So it's more research.
根据 Sweetwater Jaycees 发言人称，今年第65届年度 Sweetwater Jaycees 响尾蛇围捕活动捕获了2595磅响尾蛇，综述的记录几乎是这个数量的10倍。2016年收集了24262磅的响尾蛇。
I have heard that a lot of times they make those claims to justify collecting the venom, but really it's kind of just to show the crowd how much venom these animals can produce, which a large diamondback rattlesnake can certainly produce a large yield of venom. But I've tried to find an answer for that question, as have my colleagues, and we have not found any kind of reputable researcher or pharmaceutical company that's using venom collected from these events.